Hi guys. I thought, as I've got several computers kicking about at the moment, not doing anything, such as this Advent 3111, I'll get it out and I'll give it a boot up. I got several computers in a huge job lot. I think I paid about £100 for this job lot, cleared out from a computer shop. I don't know how many computers I got out of it, but I don't have all of them now. I actually did scrap quite a few for parts. But this was one of them, and I don't know why, I just liked the case on this one, so I kept it. And, it was built for Windows XP Home Edition, Intel Pentium 4 processor, 512MB DDR, 32x CDRW, 16x DVD. I don't know what the times is on these. It doesn't say on the front, but it does have the DVD and the CDRW. And I believe they were there when I got the case. The memory wasn't. I had to add that. The 40GB hard drive. No, there was no hard drive in any of them, so I had to put the hard drive in. But I'm not sure if I put the video card in this or if I had one in it. It should have come with a GeForce 4 MX420 64MB DDR/TV out. But it's turned on, so if I hit the button, it's actually pretty quiet. It's got vents on this side. No rear case fan. Come on. This is going to be a bitch, isn't it? Doesn't want to boot up now. Hang on. I had this running earlier. Perfectly. But if memory does serve correctly, it did get a bit temperamental. I've got nothing in these drawers, have I? Oh, there's nothing in that one. Nothing in that one. I want that blue light to come on. That's what I'm waiting for. But nope. But I can't even hear the hard drive doing anything either, so. No, the hard drive's not doing anything. What I might do. Well, this is a good start, isn't it? Right, I'm just going to unplug that for a little bit. Because there is no hard turn-off switch on this power supply. Fact, I've actually got a feeling the power supply from this will fit that. If it does, I may experiment later on today. What's the screw layout like? Because I've got a temporary one in there. It would fit. Right, so I'm going to take the case off this and see if I can get a model number for that power supply and see if by some sort of luck I can find one on perhaps eBay. Because I've always wanted to build that, because of the colour of that case, I always wanted to build that into a Windows 98. It hasn't got the ideal motherboard on it really. It works. But there's no slot on it to upgrade the video. I've currently got to get the audio to work. And this really is being a temperamental cow at the minute, isn't it? Come on, bitch. Hang on. Let's turn it off. If in doubt, give it a clout. Those lights flashed. There we go. Good old method never fails. I don't know if the internet works on this. Who is my cable? A friend of mine gave me these blue Ethernet cables when he moved out of his flat. I can't remember what he had the cables for now, but they're huge. Look at it. Blinking huge thing. The Ethernet lights are flashing, so the one that's meant to be static is there. I don't have Firefox. I think like a dipstick, I've actually wiped it off my flash drive.
Oops.
But yeah, eventually when you give it the old if in doubt give it a clout routine, it does it does work. So what I'm going to do, I'll start to unplug certain things anyway. This can go back in the bedroom, and I'm going to turn you off, and we'll go and get another one, and we'll just have a run through of my other machines and just make sure they work. Because like I said, it's been a while since I've booted any of these up. There's no telling what they've decided to do just by sitting idle. So be back shortly. Right, I've gone and got the Dell, what is it, a Dell Dimension 2400. And if my memory serves correctly, I was messing around one day and put Windows 2000 on it. So, everything's connected. I think. Did I do video? I did do video. Intel Pentium 4 inside. What's it doing? Doing a self-testy thing. I can't remember what I got to work and what I didn't get to work on this one. Hard drive has just slowed down. But yeah, this was another one I got in that job lot of computers. I actually got several of these. The various different numbers on. I know I got an 11. I actually kept one 1100, one 2400 and one 4600. But I did get duplicates of each of these, which again, I just broke for spares to keep these ones running, because I just, well, like I said, they're not really worth a great deal. I can't even remember how much RAM I've put on this. I've got the audio plugged in, because, well, like I said, I can't remember if I got that working or not. Oh, it did! Did I get internet working? I can't remember if I got Ethernet working. Yeah, I'm plugged in. The yellow light is flashing. I've got Mozilla Firefox on it. This is actually running quite quiet. If it is working like I think it is, I'll just leave it as it is. Because I was thinking of putting Windows XP back on it, but if it's going to function as a Windows 2000, which it appears it is, let's see if Firefox loads and goes online. So simple, these things. Well, it says it's transferring data from Google, so I guess it's online as well. It is. Hey, we work. I agree, yeah, blah, blah, blah. Sweet. She still works. Right. Next one I'm going to do is my Windows Millennium. I'm not going to do the ones set up in the bedroom, but what I might do is fire those ones up where they are, because they're all connected, so. Right. Let's turn the tripod around a bit. Right. So, I'll disconnect this one, take this one back into the bedroom. I'm going to put my fedora on because I feel like wearing it. It's actually quite comfy. Anyway, I'll be back in a little bit. And here's the Windows Millennium. Again, another one that came out of the huge job lot of computers I bought. I want to be around the front, don't know what to hit the button. I know this one got a bit temperamental at booting up. My first computer ever was a Windows Millennium, or Windows ME. Biggest pile of crap I'd ever used. Oh, I hated it. Oh. The adapter's not working properly. Did I password this? Yes, I did. Why, I have no idea, but I know exactly what password I'd have used. Here we go. I can play monitor, bloody blah blah. I didn't realize I had a network adapter in it. Did I not get the one on the board working? Hard drive just slowed down and started up again. Right, let's just go into properties. Why the hell are my graphics like that? Why am I on 16 colours? The hell? Yeah. Might actually have to go through my video cards and chuck one on here. But I also thought I had Etherwebs. I obviously don't have Etherwebs. Do we have Etherwebs if I connect it to the motherboard? No, because I'm going to throw the cable back on the floor. Ugh. Right, let's try again. My cable don't want to go in there. Why does the cable not want to go in? Because it's not lined up properly, that's why. Beep. That just sounds like it's got a dicky hard drive in this as well. But I am planning at some point in the future to go on eBay and see if I can find some IDE hard drives, because I've actually pretty much ran out. What did I do? I did add the sound card. Yeah, that must have been as far as I got with playing with this then. But other than that, I've got video cards in here that might work on it. I can't find the drivers for that thing. That's a PCI one as well. That one might be a little bit too new, or it might not. I've got loads in here I could chuck on it. I've got this one. I know I've got drivers for that one somewhere. What is it? It's a Matrox. But I ain't doing that now. Maybe something I'll do later. Right, let me just go and get the last one. Okay, the last Dell, and this one's a Dimension 1100. Should have checked disk drives on these, because sometimes I leave disks in there and then wonder why I can't find them. Alright. Then we'll go through to the bedroom. One thing I liked about restoring these Dells, because again, none of these came with hard drives or anything, it's just a simple fact that I could go straight on the Dell website and still get the drivers for them. Found new hardware. Let's just I didn't do a lot on this, did I? So what have I got installed on this? Got 2.5 gigahertz processor and 512 megabytes of RAM. That seems to have been my favourite choice. Windows Professional Service Pack 3. There we go, this one's all working. It's good. Restart. While that's doing that, we will go to the bedroom. While we've still got daylight. Right. So, down there are four computers. And bloody hell. Before I start, I need to clear all this junk off. Whee! Whee! I need dust down up here as well. There we go. Chuck it all on there and I'll sort it later. That'll do. Hang on a minute. Oof, a bit dusty up here as well. I'm going to have to do some dusting, but I don't have a duster at hand at the minute. Don't think. Nope, can't see one. Oh. Not another one of them flaming things. Alright then. Sat on something. Now, the way these four computers work, I'll just turn on this Optiplex. There's a GX60 Optiplex. And I've actually seen one for sale on eBay running Windows 98. I have no idea why it's running Windows 98. But that's the first one booting up. And what I'll do, I'll go down here and I'll boot up the Sony Vaio. And I'll perhaps boot up this one. Which seems to have developed an issue. We'll try the Dell 4600 instead then. But yeah, I've got issues. Now, laying on here is what they call a KVM switch. Keyboard, video, mouse. And you have a master connection up there where you connect your monitor, your actual keyboard and your mouse. And then you have these special cables that go into the back of each computer. And all I've got to do is just press this button here. And that will just switch. I didn't really. Two of the machines are booted up, but it seems like the 4600's got an issue as well. It's not found the hard drive. Primary drive not found. So I've got two computers here with an issue. Hello, what have we got going on here? That, I believe, is my Optiplex. It is my Optiplex. Right. Don't want to go into that, do I? Can't remember what specs the Optiplex is running now. The DVD and video recorder, by the way, is connected to the Vaio. Because that has got video capture on it. It's actually, I don't know if it'll work if I just tap it on my foot, will it? As you can see under the front there, which you might not, but there's RCA jacks and all sorts on there, so I can actually plug items into the front there as well. What have we got? Ooh, 2.4 gigahertz, 512 megabytes of RAM. Oh yeah, that's right. They actually allege that this GX60 can handle Um, This driver's stuck on that as well. Yay, I'm finding all sorts of problems now. You know, they say that this can take a gigabyte of RAM, but I tried that and that threw a hell of a hissy fit at me. Right, so if I just hit this button again, oof, we end up on the Sony Vaio screen. Oh, go away. Yeah, I know AVG is out of date. I've also got a hub up there for the internet. Which it's not going to have because it's not plugged in the lounge. I've forgotten to plug it back in. Right, well, I know what I'm going to be doing the rest of this afternoon. I've got to find out why these two don't work. 2 out of 4 machines working isn't good, is it? Never mind. Wait a minute. I do believe this machine hiding here, that my boot is kicking, has DDR2 memory. Which may have crapped out. There we go, see, and once you turn a machine off, it automatically switches to the next one that's turned on. Which, in this case, is the Optiplex GX60. I've got about 4 motherboards spare for this thing up in the cupboard. Right, so I'm going to shut this one down as well. And I'm just going to stand you on the tripod. If I've got a video of any repairs, I'll do that in a separate video. But for now, I'm just going to move this box out of the way. Come down here and drag the machine out. Just full of dirt. Right, what have we got? What's the USB cable for? I've got a USB cable plugged into this and I have no friggin' idea what it goes to. Unplug it. Heck, if this has got the DDR2 memory in it and whatnot, I think I'll use this one as a parts computer and build up the other one. Or modify the other one. Just trying to get the DVR adapter off. Right, so. This is actually quite light, I can grab it one-handed. Let's just have a look inside this one before I end the video. Oh crap, I've got to do that, haven't I? Oh well, scrub that plan. I'm going to stop the video here then. I'll shut this down. So, out of I forget how many computers, only 2 of them have actually failed to work. Which isn't bad really, is it? So the other thing I like about these Dells, I've got these lights on here that light up and show you if there's any error. They actually light up an error code. Right. Get some lights back on. Take this one down out of the way for a minute. This is one I got given by a friend. Was running Windows 7 with 512 megabytes of RAM, DDR2 RAM. I'm just going to quickly strip this side off. Whoops. I'm going to throw screws down on the floor. Right. Get this side panel off. It was working when I stuck it down there, but like I said, you just don't know what's going to happen. Right, so we've got 1 memory stick in here. It could be that's failed. It's a 2 GB stick. So that means I can actually upgrade that one straight away. We've also got a video card. We've also got SATA hard drives. Ooh. Oh yeah. That's actually why I use this case. Right. Just reseat the RAM and we'll just give it one more boot up and see what happens. It was beeping an error code at me, but I couldn't hear it properly. Go and just grab the thingamajig. But yeah, if anyone else wants to do a setup like I've got in the bedroom, just get yourself a KVM switch and the cables. Easy. And you can get them for USB sockets as well. Right, 2 seconds. Use the KVMs with PS2 connections. You can get them with the USBs for your mouse and keyboard. Right, I'll put power in. Yes. I don't know what I've done, but it seems to be working now. That had a very rapid beep earlier. Nope, OCD left in that one. Yeah, another one of them PCIe video cards somewhere. But there's no drivers for Windows 7 for that one. It works on Windows 7, but it doesn't like it. What else have I got on there? I've got the extra USB ports on there as well. Why the hell would I put them on there? It's got 4 there. 3 on the front, if we count the one on the card reader. Now what's the bet? And I'll go and put the side cover back on this, go stick it back under the thing, and the whole thing will die. I can't remember if my other XP over there's got SATA hard drive in it. I don't think so. I think it's all IDE. Oddly. Ooh. No boot up. Oh, there we go. I was going to say no boot up. I think eventually I will probably just scrap this one because it's not the best case in the world either. In fact, I might just do that anyway. Just because. it is fire damaged there. Yeah, it was actually built for Windows XP. But, even know what gigabyte those drives are. Let's just have a quick look. See sort of the specifications this one is running. Right, let's go into system. We know it's got 2 GB of RAM. Oh, it's got a 3 GHz processor. Pentium 4 though. So it's not a dual core. Just a Pentium 4. Which means my other one is actually better because it's a dual core. So we have, hard drive wise, that's a 300 gig and a 80 gig. Really? That is it? Okay. Shut this one down. I'm not going to stick this one in then. This one's going to be taken apart. Ooh, 500 watt power supplies. I could upgrade the power supply as well. Guess what I'm going to be doing later? I might even upgrade the heat sink as well from this one. And transplant it into my one up the corner. If I can be in the mood for computers later, that's the one I want to get done and upgraded, because I really don't like this case because it's got a big gaping hole in the front anyway. But I'd have a spare motherboard that would go in that case over there as well should I need it. So I mean, I don't need two XP gaming e-rigs, do I? Because I've got all those games up on the shelf. Right. Anyway, this has been quite a long video. I do apologise for that, but it is what it is, as a fellow YouTuber says. Anyway, thanks for watching. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. Entirely up to you. Subscribe if you haven't already. Much appreciated. And maybe once I've given the camera another charge, I might video myself doing some upgrades. So, talk to you later.